Axel.
Yeah. Axel. I'm gonna give it to him like that. It's Fabi. You know the vibes. Fuck. Free souls.
Be me and Swag.
Guap.
Cali, man.
El Guapo.
Yeah. Q.
In the spot. I'm Jack. Perk head.
You know the vibes.
Big GK shit. Bow.
Swag.
Bow. Hold on. Love. Yeah. Big drip,
big drip.
I fell in love with a lit bitch.
Ayy,
crip shit.
Ayy,
she wanna suck on a lit dick.
Ayy.
Couple bitches I get lit with. Couple bitches I get lit with. I been spent. I give a fuck who you been with.
Ayy.
Bow. They loving the style.
They loving the style.
Send me the Addy, I'm hunting them down. Send me the Addy, I'm hunting them down. Bow. Grip. Bow. Bitch, I'm on demon time. Straightforward, I don't need a line.
I don't.
I just wanna watch it the free time.
I did.
I bought it with me, I ain't leaving mine. Bow. I bought it with me, I ain't leaving mine.
There has been a lot of violence. And I think that activism has become a new hustle. And I believe that a lot of the young people have not bought in. Rappers that are coming today and the church will come together to stand and say here's another option, a different way to do this. Right? So in order for us to both change, we gotta be the change. So that's what we're doing. Like what you see, young people, I don't want it just to be on me. It's not about me. But it's about all the young people that are here. Because I'm nothing. It's about people that's coming together. The real white people coming together. We got a record page on here already. We have a big we here. We got a magic, we have Chief. Harrison, we have a lot of different artists that are here, and it takes a village to create a great community, and we have, that's what we need.
Well, I'm not worried about it, it's just something that happens, you know, and to worry is great freedom, but we try to both change, that's what we want. We want to both change, we want to set a different atmosphere to the community, and we want to send a different message. Always, a lot of times, elderly people walk in. This is not a kumbaya march. This is not a stop the violence. No, this is a peace. Everybody's peace. We have gang members coming together. We're all coming together in love. We're all coming together in integrity. And that's what we do.
today was a good protest. We came out today, the celebrities, gang bangers, gang members, all types of people from the neighborhoods came out together as one to represent Black Lives Matter, black on black crime, striving to stop our people from killing each other. In this day and time, you know, it's not about killing each other no more. We're trying to come together to make a new environment for our people, a new world, you know, a new world order for the people to be able to come across new things in life, to be able to have a better community for our youth, to be able to live and play in the playgrounds, to be able to come outside and mingle and play basketball.
Right here between you. Slide over a little bit. Here we go. Right. Y'all slide a little bit.
Further down. Good. Oh, there we go.
Still are valued. They still have purpose. And when we allow them to live in who God made them, then I think we can change. They say, Bishop, why are you bringing the streets together? Why are you bringing gang members together? Why are you still dealing with hip-hop communities? I said, because I believe that they're the prophets of this time. I believe that they have a story to tell. They just need direction. They need somebody that they can trust. You know, I'm mentoring Favi now, and he's just all about the children. He has a foundation that he's giving back to the community. He wants to do the right thing. He wants to lead a good cause. Every person that you see behind me has a purpose. Who are we to take that purpose from them? We need to stop gang violence. We need to stop gun violence. This is why we're here all together, and I keep turning around because I don't want to be the person that y'all looking at, because I'm nothing without them. I'm nothing. I made a clarion call out, and I would have been here by myself if I don't give them the love and respect, because they supported us. And I need y'all to understand, people lie, numbers don't. And we have the power. We just gotta know how to use the power. And as I spoke to different gang members and different leaders, you know what I told them? I need y'all to come as you are. Don't try to change who you are, but that's not the real you. Come as you are. The bishop got your back. The board president got your back. Chief Harrison got your back. Angela Yee got your back. Asia Whitehead got your back. Inspector Faison got your back. Chief Madry got your back. We got their back just who they are. My father was killed by 16 police officers. He was beaten, strangled to death because of the color of his skin. But that does not diminish my relationship with the NYPD. That makes me want to strengthen the relationship so therefore I can have an understanding, and we can have an understanding, and we can move together as one body. In the book of Acts, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit came when they was all on one accord. Now this generation is on one accord. And when we speak, the Holy Spirit got us. Because that's what the scripture says. We want to stop violence. Today Juve. Today is Juve, right? I've been in Brooklyn 42 years, born and raised. And every single year somebody dies. That's what this march is about. It's about peace. It's about unity. We're not doing no kumbaya. We're not on bullhorns. We're not doing that. We're walking with peace. And the elected officials are standing behind us. The NYPD is standing with us. And the people, the most important, is standing with us. And I just want y'all to just take a look at the souls that are behind me. Because it's because of them that we have strength. It's because of them they give us the purpose today. They have the voice. They voice travel. They voice have substance. And I just want to say this. I believe in each and every one of y'all. Every single one of you, I believe in. And if you do, and they know me, a lot of them know me. What I can't say five times, I won't say once. If I say I believe in you, I believe in you. And I believe in them. And I believe in change. And we have Fabio here. We have Angela Yee. And I want Fabio to come up and say a few words as far as what he's doing with the community. And he has his foundation.
Yeah, so I started something called Farside Foundation, right? Farside Foundation, it gives back to like people like me who was probably like homeless at a point in life, or like, you feel me, like, or going through some, or need somebody to talk to, right? So I started that to help like children, and like my most important thing right now is like Black Lives Matter. Like, we gotta stop police brutality. We gotta tell our kids that it's a better way to go. I don't want the kids to look at me and think that they gotta join things and go fight like go away. Like, I know a new way now, so I be telling like kids like do the right thing.
Okay, good. So what I'm saying is this. This is what we're doing. He started a foundation. He's using his voice. He has music that's touching the world.
I wanna shout out my big brother Gutter, because I'm also doing this for P Gutter. P Gutter, like, he really want me to do something positive too. And right now he in jail, like, stopping gang violence in a way, in his own little way. So he pushing me to do this too.
So there's young men that's in Rikers Island right now, and I've been on the phone with them. Not only are we stopping the violence right here, but the young man, Gutta, he's actually spearheading stopping slashing in Rikers Island and throughout the state. So I've been in contact with him, and I also spoke to the board president, and we're going to go in and have a conversation with them, and we're going to help them lead the way. Because we're not one-sided. We got brothers and sisters that's in prison. And the young man, Pete Gutter, right? He called, we spoke numerous times, and he wanted to do the right thing. He's already doing the right thing. He's stopping slashing, cutting. He's stopping gang wars inside of the penitentiary, places that some of you never been. So I'm telling you guys, I want y'all to look at all of these people back here. Our arms are long. Our arms stretch. Angela Yee from 105.1. Want to have some words?
Hey, I just wanted to thank you guys for having me here today. You know, I'm from Brooklyn. I still live in Brooklyn. I know a lot of people get money and they move out of Brooklyn, but it was really important for me to stay here. I have my Juice Bar in Best-Buy. I did that in Best-Buy because as we can see with coronavirus and the pandemic, our community is always being targeted, whether it's health issues, whether it's violence in our communities, you know, all the disparities in the education system. So it's always been really important for me to represent for us And I do want to say that I want to make sure that this is a community where our kids can feel safe to go outside and play, right? Where people that move here, and we need to be invested in the community more than people that are coming here, moving here, gentrifying things. We need to make sure that we take care of ourselves and take care of our own and show each other love. And I do feel like it takes a bigger man and a bigger woman to say, excuse me, I don't want to get into this. I don't want us to have this fight. I don't want us to get into a violent altercation with each other. It takes a big, big man and a big, big woman to be able to say, yo, let's just watch this because people are watching us. And right now, we don't know what's going on in people's lives. Everybody's going through it. So let's all have some empathy for each other and some love for each other. That's what Brooklyn's supposed to be about.